Welcome back. We were playing some more games on Shogi Wars. We got some friends joining us. I don't know what the stream delay is like. Sorry about that. But yeah, here our game conditions. Normal game, 10 minutes, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's seek a game. Let's fix the overlay and not forget to shift the volume back down to 80% because the site is loud. Good luck. Oh, we were sent to this game. All right, let's continue our long-standing tradition of playing Central File. Yeah. And then bring this out. Ah. Yeah, there was a proverb that rolled right before this. The sideways action of the rook. Hang on. Is strong in defense. And there was a question, why does that sound so dirty? Yeah, that's sideways action. Ooh, so sideways. Is it dirty? I thought rooks moved sideways. Now bishops go diagonally. Is that dirty? So we're playing some hybrid stuff here, where I get to put. Okay, we are ducking out of here, man. We are so far out. All right, so yeah, those crooked bishops. They can't help it though. That's just in their nature. Moving diagonally. Ah, right. I'm supposed to oppose this advance when they do it. I didn't in this case, so maybe I'll pay a price for that. On the other hand, I did prevent them from using their bishop immediately, but this could be difficult. Okay, they moved their king to the left, which we are so ready for. Oh, they're bringing their rook around. That's interesting. I bring this up, it becomes harder for me to attack. Moving my knight limited my options here. I should not have moved the knight. Or I should have been prepared that this could get difficult. So, to free my knight. I want to open this file that their king is on. To do that, I've got to move the bishop. To move the bishop, this seems to. Oh. Wait, there's complications here, too. Because they could drop a pawn on my knight's head if they see that. So, we have a pawn in hand now. And we want to break open the file that their king is sitting on. This game gets more and more interesting by the move. Okay. Don't understand that. So we clearly dominate the center. This 5-5 point is clearly ours. And now we get to take this point too. And maybe, I mean, yeah, their bishop advances. I'm a bit scared about that, but I'm optimistic for my own attacking chances somehow. So let's try this. And try this, I guess. I guess my domination of the center isn't absolute. If I push, silver takes, pawn takes, gold take. I have a fork.
Nanafun.
We're gonna exchange rooks if I advance. Which I think is fine by me. This is dangerous, but I like playing with fire. Ah! So now I don't have a fork. Okay. That did not work how I thought. On the other hand, their gold is in this odd position. Fine. Let's see how this plays. I'm defending my rook. My rook can move. And if they take this gold, then yeah, their bishop escapes. So we're gonna walk into a fork, and it's going to be glorious. There's the fork. Where's the glory? I don't know. If I drop the bishop back, I lose a bishop. That's not so smart. If I drop a bishop here and then advance the knight, I've got tactics. Tactics are modestly interesting. Sure, why not? So I attack the dragon. I'm also threatening to drop a silver, exchanging off my knight and silver for a rook. So let's do that. They do not cooperate, so that's fair. Me strike again. And I thought I had some way to continue this. Maybe not. I don't know. They have a dragon. I open this up.
Gohun.
At least immediately, I don't die. There's no reason for me to open that. Maybe there are reasons. What a strange position. Okay, I activate my bishop. Can't drop a pawn there. If I drop, they put a pawn in the way. They're threatening my silver. What a mess. Now I have to defend. This sucks. All right, we defend. It sucks. This is known. Yeah, let's take that. Okay. That definitely attacks my pieces. Nope, that's this lance drop is misguided. I could drop a lance
Sanbun.
here. That could be interesting. Let's sack my horse, because sacrificing pieces can be fun. I thought this would be reasonable. Maybe it's not. Yeah, their king just escapes my web of pieces. without much effort. Fair enough. My bishop is hanging. Alright, so we continue keeping our bishop as a target that they can hit easily. I don't know why, but bishops are cool, I guess. Just take that. Okay, my base silver cannot take that. Kind of goaded into taking this, whether or not that works. Which it seems not to work. Okay. Oh. There's problems everywhere here. It's not check, but it's powerful. I don't know. My king does not survive this for very long. I can take that, and I have to, but. Yeah, that's mate. Thanks for the game. Well played. All right. Are we all ready for me to try another game? I know some of us are trying to snipe for me. Should I wait a bit? Should I play the next one right away? What's our proverb gonna be? Aim with the ranging rook at bishop exchange. Yeah, so here we did play a ranging rook. A lot of stuff got exchanged this game. All right, let's do it. Here we go. We'll see if we can get the random pairing. Good luck. It seems unlikely that we're gonna get the random pairing unless I like elevate my rating a little bit. I mean, it's their time to spend or not spend, so if they don't use it, they don't have to. It is irksome when, like, you beat an opponent and it's because they haven't used their time and you know they could do better. But, yeah. that kind of anguish aside, I mean, it's up to players to choose how they want to use their time. I'm confused already. All right, let's bring the silver up just to make things extra fun. Here we go. And there we continue. So we are far off the beaten path. I don't know which way I intend to move my king. Oh, well. Interesting. So if silver somehow got exchanged, this position would be fine. Let's bring the bishop out this way. Oh, you find it irksome that they play well and defeat you despite playing quickly. Yeah, that's not my problem. They're just that good. Okay. We've got an opening on our hands, guys. I think Shogi Wars has noticed that I've lost a few games recently. Yeah, so if silver's exchange, I have this fork, which it works better for me than it works for them. I think our opponent wants out of this madness. I'm gonna try tucking my king to the left, like they're doing with their king, even though all my generals are on the right side of the board. I think it's still okay. Yeah, we'll resist against this edge. And if they push the other edge, we'll resist there as well. I could have aimed for a bishop exchange. That would be something. So generally, I tend to put this pawn on 5-5 and only push it when it wins the game. And so that way I know that, hey, when I push this, I'm going to win. So it's nice when you can have a plan and it works out that way. I see. So they're trying to bring pressure over here. I'm going to do the super inadvisable. Oh, my silver's too loose. I can't do that. I have to do this first. But yeah, actually, I should use both of my silvers and not try to force things here. But if I push this pawn, this position could get wide open very quickly. So, yeah, moving the knight out would encourage their silver to move one direction or another here. Note that, well, I've blocked my rook. I would like my rook. Have I accessed? Well, okay, I have transposed into Urushino territory. Not entirely accidentally. But I was about to have a bit of a conniption if, like, accidentally I transposed into this, but no, I just kind of tend to lean toward this. The fact that they gave up the pawn was the surprising bit, not the fact that my bishop and silver are aligned and ready for me to eventually strike on this file. No, that's not a surprise. The surprise is that I got the free pawn. Another surprise is that they're opening the path for me to invade. That was optional. Oh, they're trying to block my knight. Okay. Now I understand that better. I mean, there's nothing that says I have to invade. Let's put some pressure on this edge before everything explodes and my king's in the wrong spot.
7分.
They don't have a pawn, so I can push this way. Central Rook Urashino. Yes. This is the new meme, guys. This is how we know if you're loyal to this channel. You play Central Rook Urashino. And I guess you put your king on the left when you do this. I don't know. At least when this sort of thing happens. Putting the king anywhere else seems pretty dubious. But okay, they broke my silver fork that I'd been threatening, so. Let's cool off a bit. The rook is no longer invading on this file. Yes, I can just bring the rook over this way. Like, this is super weird. Oh, the rook's threatening to invade again. So, I guess we go back. Maybe. I mean, going back up here doesn't seem so bad. The king's over here. I'm aiming the wrong direction. But I don't want their rook to invade. If they had a pawn in hand, this would be bad news for me. Okay, that's fair. I saw that even. Tried to process it in my head, couldn't process it, and just moved on. But, yeah, there's definitely a point there. If I push this pawn, I don't successfully invade, do I? Yeah, I do. But they invade too. What a mess. What an incredible mess. How do I not get this level of a mess? If I
5分.
take and then I bring my silver forward, I save a tempo and hopefully don't lose the game. If I push this pawn, there are things they can do to attack. Wait a second, if they exchange silver generals, I have threats. All right, we're gonna play this and pretend it's fine. I have the silver drop threat because their bishop is wedged between the gold and the rook. At least right now it is. I may be going to exchange my rook for a bishop here. I haven't decided yet. But the clock keeps ticking, and I want to make a move. Silver takes looks reasonable. So they still can't invade, but they could bring this gold up and get a super weird castle shape. And then I can drop my rook back and defend this point so that if they drop a silver, I don't like lose everything. Or I could go over here, get a bishop, but No, this seems a more reasonable approach somehow. So now comes the bad news of them finding some tactic that rains all over my parade and ruins everything I've worked for. All right, so I don't think that was it. No, in fact, that's a free silver. Thanks for the game. Yeah, there's the silver exchange. All right, transport. Are we ready for attempt three? Yeah, that was a free silver. There is a Shogi proverb about taking pieces. It goes, take pieces. Yeah, the 5E Vanguard pawn is the strategic point. So when I push that, I won. That's how I said it works, right? But that's not always so simple. But transport, if you're trying to snipe me, should I go? Let me know. We can hang on a little bit, enjoy this little discussion we're having here. Although I can't imagine your game that you've got in progress goes for another 5 minutes or so. I don't have any way to check if you're in the midst of a game or not. So here I am vamping a bit. This is an interesting castle, the twin gold with silver here. I've never seen twin gold in response to central file rook. And I guess this central file Urushino might just be the vaccine to that. Okay, might as well just go. Fair enough. We can always play a game some other time. Yeah, let's not stall. Let's just go for it. Yeah, our game finished 10 minutes in because we both missed things. Good luck. All right. Central foul, here we go, against an opponent who's won two games in sequence. Oh. Okay. Still gonna play this. We're not going to get psyched out too badly by whatever our opponent is up to. Right hand, fourth file rook. Yeah, there it is. And. Okay. Let's not keep the king in the center of the board. And now, if I push this, this becomes a target. If I push my center pawn, now if I just exchange silver takes, I lose a tempo. Yeah, let's not go there. Let's just plug this and assume I've got everything under control. Which can backfire. Often amazingly so. So yeah, maybe I bring up my silver to hit this. I don't know. If they're playing right hand fourth file rook, the whole point is they want to open this file for their rook. So it's not smart for me to keep my pieces on it. On the other hand, we might have a different castle on our hands entirely. Let's just keep moving the king out and see what they're up to. All right, they're attacking my center pawn. They have three pieces attacking this, and I've not defended my bishop. Bad news for me. I lose a pawn. That's not great at all. All right, let's protect the bishop so at least I can start to mitigate the damage that's gonna fall out from this. But yeah, this is gonna be bad. This is what happens when you very much misplay the opening. So Yeah, maybe I should have moved the silver instead of that one. Maybe I need all my generals next to my king. Maybe I'm just a bit tilted. All right, let's move this one. So they can try to claim this vanguard pawn while their king still sits in the center. Of course, I'm going to fight back against this, but I don't have a pawn in hand. So it's very difficult for me to fight back. I can still build Kimura Amino. Can still try to. I don't know. This also gives my silver somewhere to retreat to in the event that things go horribly wrong. Yeah, his king is unsafe. And if silver's exchange, I have some fun tactics on my side. If silver's exchange. They attack my bishop's head directly. What a mess. All right, let's. Screw it. Let's live a little. Let's die a little. This is going to be terrible, but we'll have lived for it. So. Wait, they can't easily defend this pawn, can they? So I was mentioning if a silver's exchange, I have a silver drop hitting the rook and the gold, and then they can move the silver and I take a rook. So let's offer a silver exchange instead of just letting them take all of our pieces directly. Okay. I expected they might do something like that. It's actually pretty effective. It's so effective, we can do it too. Except theirs is better. I'm trying to claim the square in front of this pawn. It's not going well. But my king is slightly better defended for one turn. What is this rook going to do anyway if it runs away? Like, it can defend the lance. We were just reading a proverb about how effective the rook is at sideways defense. And I forgot about that proverb. Forgetting is bad. If I take this rook,
Nanafun.
I don't win. Not on the spot. If I take this gold, my attack continues. Man, this is rough. I don't know what to do. Oh, I have an idea. Let's tempt fate a bit. If gold takes, we have another silver drop. They didn't take that way. So instead, we do have a rook drop, and then we can collect the pawn. We don't need to do that right away. Let's take here first. So they don't have a lance. Which means I can check here and then take back. And yes, they can obtain a lance, they just don't have one yet. So we have survived their central file rook attack. We duped them into playing a central file rook attack and then conned them out of taking a free rook. What will we do next? I don't know. It wasn't free. I'm overstating my claims for humorous effect, but man, it's been a stressful game. The even more stressful bit is that they could take this lance, and I could fork them, and I don't know where we end up next. If I don't fork them, if I try to run out of the corner, I can't fully trap this. So, like, the best way to use my bishop is to exchange it for their horse, if they'll give me that. If they'll give me it. They might not. Oh, plus here, now they have this sudden threat to drop a lance in front of my rooks, which I don't want to see happen. So we will fight like this. Their horse ends up in the corner, my horse ends up in the other corner, and I don't know where we go next. Okay, they try to trap my horse. My shape is not very secure at all. If I chase this gold, I could use that to
Go
collect
free.
this bishop. And the circle of life repeats. Also, I could just use this gold to chase that, but it's such a pitiful use of a piece. Okay, so the main reason I was concerned about this is what if they drop a silver to defend this? But I don't know that that should be my main concern here, given, like, this is a really messy position. Them choosing to put a silver in space should not be my largest concern. Because I could move the pawn and drop another pawn, but then they could drop a lance on my rooks, and I have no pawn to interpose. So that's one way things can go. My rooks are not active. Okay, that didn't concern me so much. What to do? Let's tempt fate again. They're going to have a lance drop. I'm going to lose material from this, but I don't see any better way to attack here. So I guess I'm just kind of melting down or something, not thinking clearly enough. I don't know. I'm engaging in wishful thinking. Some might call it dreaming. I thought that that was going to work out for me. Oh, I could sack the horse for a gold general. Yeah, that, I guess that would not be unreasonable. Even here, that isn't the worst idea. Here it's getting worse and worse by the move, though.
2分30秒.
Yeah, I just cannot find a move to save my butt. Okay, there's a move. We found something. It's not great. Oh, right. Forgot about that. All right.
2分.
Okay, how they're gonna ruin my day right now? I wonder. I was seeing this lance drop earlier, but this right in front of the rook, I can't interpose. Although interposing wouldn't matter if the interposition square is attacked by the horse anyway. What a mess. It's a good thing I didn't exchange everything. If they take the rook, silver takes looks safest. Even here. No, I should take this. Otherwise, these checks next to my king are just super painful. Oh dear. I need this. So the rook is protected. The silver is hanging. I forgot that the silver is hanging, so they have a rook fork. Yeah, that sucks.
1分30秒.
Let's try not to get mated. Nope, that ain't useful. Oh dear. Oh me, oh my. Oh me, oh my. I. My opponent is playing well, but I'm not pleased with the way my standard of play.
1分.
Let's try to do something. Oh, I didn't. That's not defended. Okay. Let's try to do something, even in the case where they're not reacting to my moves. Yeah, I am mated. This is something. All right, let's pretend they'll react to this, because either way, I'm doomed. They actually do react. Okay. Let's make use of that. Don't know what I'm doing. Okay, if my king's going to escape, I need to move the knight out of the way.
30秒.
Nah, it just gets surrounded. Yeah. Thanks for the game. Well played. All right. Well, things happened in these three games. Stuff happened, that's for sure. So yeah, we are now at 17.6%, or if we make our way all the way down to 0% and then a little bit beyond, we'd be in the 2Q category again. Hopefully that doesn't happen. It helps to understand what I'm doing. And with time, hopefully I build up good experience rather than bad. But you never know. So there's going to be things to look at. Engine-san will tell us this third game some of the things that were missed. Our opponent has played many, many games. So yeah, congrats to them as they continue winning. I hope the best for them. Yeah, and maybe, I don't know. I'm not sure what to say. I need to practice more sumo shogi, and if I study those a bit more, then I'll have better ideas about how to approach these castles in the first place and not feel that it's such a futile task. So, hope you enjoyed that, and thanks for watching.